Hello friends, today another one new solid we are going to solve, which is that just we will have its narration. First of all, a triangular prism possessing 35 mm side and 70 mm height is resting on one of its base corner. Resting element is base corner on vertical plane with axis inclined to vertical plane by 45 degrees and its front view is inclined to HP by to horizontal plane by 50 degrees. Complete the projections. Okay, so what is mentioned here, first inclination is with regard to axis of the solid and second inclination is nothing but directly the front view, entire front view what we are going to get as its fourth image, that we have to tilt by that inclination which is mentioned as 50 degrees with HP. Okay, so one by one we'll start. So first figure, what we have to find out from this narration, which kind of solid is nothing but triangular prism. Okay, and it is going to rest on which element, that is base corner, and next is on which principal plane it is going to rest on one of its base corner, that is vertical plane. So we should initiate by constructing this first image, that is true shape of the base of the solid, that is triangle, on that vertical plane by taking into consideration the resting corner on our right hand. So about this resting corner, that is C dash, this point is here, the solid will be tilting in further views. Okay, so initially we have drawn this true shape of the base, that is equilateral triangle, in this way, and all the corners, as because this is a prism, it is carrying top face as well as base and rectangular lateral surfaces. So six names I have put here, 1, 2, 3 for top corners, ABC for base corners. Okay, accordingly first figure we have completed as primary front view image, as it is resting on VP. So first figure we have drawn as good as it is going to rest on its base, not on corner. So first figure we have drawn that entire base is resting on VP. So accordingly the second image will be, top view image will be like this. If the entire base is on VP, so its image of that base, that is ABC, that we should draw over HRL only. XY and HRL we have drawn here, VP, HP are written here. So base first of all we should take on VP in this way, on HRL in this way, as because it is resting on VP without any inclination to any one of the element of this solid. We have drawn this set in this way. ABC corners I have marked here, axis I have drawn here, and height of the solid is given as 70 mm. Accordingly, in primary top image, this will appear like this. 1, 2, 3 is here, ABC is here. So first image, this one is the second image. First set we have finished, primary front end top images. Now third figure will carry the first inclination. We know that third figure always carries the first inclination from the narration. So first inclination is with regard to axis. This axis is continuous thin chain which we have drawn here, which is the axis. It should carry the first inclination, as it is mentioned as 45 degrees with VP. Inclination made by line with VP, it should be shown over HP. By that law, first of all we should draw this axis at an angle of 45 degrees. But we know that this axis is, in case of prism, it is parallel to the lateral edge or lateral surface. So naturally, inclination carried by this C3, this edge, will be same as good as this center line. So what we have to do? We should tilt this C3 line so that, as per the narration, C will be on the HRL itself. So about this C only, this is the resting corner as per our narration. entire solid should be tilted with VP. So this C I have taken here, any distance we can maintain conveniently. Okay, C I have put here, and after that at an angle of 45 degrees in this direction, 45 degree inclination we should give, and that line we should construct here as C3. First of all, continuous thin line, construction line you can draw, and after that shift this length by compass only. Compass will help a lot, help you a lot. Just like this. Every time don't use scale. Compass is your best friend. So transfer this C3 first of all here. Accordingly complete the rectangle. You know how to complete C, A, B, 1, 2 and 3. As entire figure you have to pick from here and place here, so that C should be over HRL. It should not leave HRL. Okay, it should not be distant from HRL. It should be all the time above HRL. Accordingly, this figure I have drawn. So naturally, as C3 is making 45 degree axis, it is also parallel to this. We know, everybody knows this. That's why this 45 degree. Once again, I have written here. That's because this axis is also carrying the same inclination. Now, second, this one is the third figure. The fourth figure, as for the third, we have to give that effect of thick as well as dotted. Now, in this third figure, I have put here upward arrow. Now, you have to observe. All the observers have to come over here and observe this figure, so that visible and invisible things, which are equally important, that effect we have to give in the fourth image. So, from this arrow, in this direction you have to observe, naturally this top face 1, 2, 3, all these corners are towards the observer. Those are visible to the observer. That's why immediately those corners we should give by thick effect. Similarly, this resting corner is farthest point. See here. And it is still totally hidden below this object. So this C, it is here. So connecting base edges as well as lateral edge, but all the three lines should be connected by dash medium thick lines in this way. So C dash, B dash, C dash, A dash and C dash, 3 dash. These three lines, those are not visible to the observer in this direction. That's why those should be connected by dash medium thick lines. Okay. How to get this ABC and 1, 2, 3, we have learnt in the last session. Okay, still, once again we will revive. How to get this image? Just get the horizontal projections from all the corners of this first image in this way, through all the three corners. And vertically from third image, vertically up through all the corners in this way. And intersecting points, you are going to give the names. See here, A, it will run horizontally, A vertically, A dash. Similarly, one horizontally, one is here, one vertically, one dash. Likewise, all ABC as well as 1, 2, 3 names we can give. And thick and dotted effect, which by this arrow only we have got here, and the same we have computed. So this is the second set, in which this is the secondary front image and this is the secondary top image. Now fifth image will be adjacent to fourth and it will carry the second inclination. Now the second inclination is mentioned with regard to entire front view image. Means this entire front view should be tilted by 50 degree inclination with HP. Inclination with HP should be shown over VP. So accordingly now this fourth image, now you have to circumscribe in a four-sided rectangle. Just see here. It has been circumscribed here by four-sided rectangle. Now this figure you have to pick from here, and this resting element is this corner C dash, and this line C dash, 3 dash. So this resting element, that is corner, base corner, and connecting C dash, 3 dash, this base edge, vertical edge, which is hidden, it should carry that 50 degree inclination. So accordingly the entire figure you have to pick from here and place here, so that this entire figure will carry 50 degree inclination. So naturally see here, C dash, 3 dash is also making an inclination of 50 degrees to HP. How I have drawn? Same way. It has been circumscribed here. So this rectangle is with us the very faint lines I have drawn here. Okay, so what I have done here, so this B dash up to this corner, this length I have picked from here and I have placed on this line initially, which is initially I have drawn by protractor with 50 degree inclination with HP. On that I have picked this length, entire length of this rectangle, and I have placed here anywhere you can place, anywhere. It should not touch HRL, that you should take care of. Okay, it should not touch HRL. So this distance, any distance we can maintain. And here I have shifted that length of the rectangle. This is the width of the rectangle and completed the entire figure. All the corners as it is, with the thick as well as dotted effect. Same effect should be carried here, should be carried forward here. Okay. So this is the front view image. Fifth image is as good as actual front view image as per our narration. And here, up downward arrow I have put here in order to get its last, that is top image. Same way. Now this has been tilted by 50 degrees. So as per the narration, second inclination to the front view we have given, and front view is carrying 50 degree inclination. Now ultimately we should conclude with its last view, that is top image. Okay, so stretch all the projections vertically down through all the base corners as well as top corners of this front view in this way, and horizontally from this fourth image in this way. Now intersecting points of A horizontal, A vertical, B horizontal, B vertical, likewise by the same method, nothing is new. You can get this figure as its top image. A, B, C, 1, 2, 3. Intersecting points I have named here, and accordingly serially all the points have been connected here. So ultimately this figure is our top image. Okay, now the thick and dotted effect, again in this direction, in downward direction we are observing from top, so naturally it is resting on C dash. We are observing from front, so connecting to C dash, A dash C dash, B dash C dash, these two passages as well as this lateral edge C dash 3 dash, which is vertical one, these three are totally invisible in front view. So you are observing from top. Now these are towards the arrow. See here, while observing from top, this A dash 1 dash as well as C dash 3 dash are towards the arrow, towards the observer. So these two lines initially should be thick. See here, A1 is here, C3 is here, both are visible. Okay, and farthest line is B2. It is far away from arrow, naturally it should be hidden. See here, B2 is hidden. Okay, in this way dotted and thick effect we have shown here, A, B, C, as well as this 2B, this lateral edge and two base edges are not visible while observing from top. Those should be shown by dash medium thick lines. Entire other lines should be connected by thick lines. So in this way, the last set, which is nothing but the actual front view and top view images as per the given narration, we have concluded this solution.